Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Truro Cathedral for the second phase of the competition aspect of this wonderful festival. I'm sorry the weather has taken a slight turn for the worse. We nearly got away with it, but this is, after all, Cornwall, and so we would sort of semi-expect a little bit of dampness along the way. But whatever happens outside, it should not at all detract from the glorious sounds that we will hear inside here, with young people singing and then choirs over the number 40, not age of 40, but over the 40 in strength, competing a little later on this afternoon. You're in for a feast of music making, and you're very welcome to be here to enjoy it all. Just a couple of air stewarding notices before we begin, that please do ensure that your mobile phones are switched off or at least onto silent. If we have to evacuate the building for any reason, do please follow the directions of the stewards, and they will usher you through the main entrance of the cathedral at the back of the building from where I'm standing now. If you wish to use the facilities for any stage in the afternoon, offer my right-hand side through the big wooden door over there, and there, on the corridor on the right as you go through there. I'll now hand you over to our wonderful compere, who will guide you through the next few hours. Are you here all afternoon? Oh, good. The next few hours of this wonderful music making. And enjoy. It's lovely to see you all here.
Good afternoon, and welcome once again to another afternoon of glorious music making as part of the Cornwall International Male Choral Festival. This session begins with the International Youth Gala Concert and Competition for the John Langdon Cup and the Kelwood Cup for the most entertaining youth performance. So please welcome once again our panel of esteemed adjudicators, David Sadlier, Christopher Gray, Dobrinka Tabakova, Russell Pascoe and Jakob Martinets, ably chaired by the Artistic Director of the Festival, Gareth Churcher. The first choir to perform for us this afternoon is the Knaben Cantori Basel from Switzerland, and their musical director is Oliver Rudin and staging director Daniel Rauflub. They're going to sing for us Vajela Jumala Suasta by Velio Turnis, Psalm 121 by John Anthony Derung, Je ne mange point de peau by Claudine de Sermacy, and It Don't Mean a Thing by Duke Ellington. We welcome them to the stage. And as they're coming on, I can tell you a little bit about them. They are a boys and young men choir based in Basel in Switzerland, and performing here for us today are the 35 tenors and basses. Please welcome them.
Thank you. Thank you.
the Knaben Cantori Basel, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for starting off our afternoon with such excitement. And you can certainly see why that choir is invited to all sorts of festivals all over the world, including Lucerne, Minsk, Maastricht, Venice, Poznan, to name just a few. They're also the host choir of the famous European Festival of Youth Choirs, and they regularly perform in opera productions at the Theatre Basel. Our next choir that we're going to hear this afternoon is the Truro School Barbershop Boys, and their musical director is Mark Hounsell. You'll see this afternoon that the choir have been experimenting with singing without a conductor and been working very much on their awareness of ensemble. It's a young and diverse group, and they sing in many different genres, and although their repertoire is often light-hearted and entertaining, they demonstrate a serious and genuine commitment to the music. They've already chalked up many years of singing and performing experience between them, even though they're so young. And most of the boys also sing in the school's chamber choir and were former boy choristers here at Truro Cathedral. During the last few years, the barbershop's been involved in a number of concerts ranging from the school's annual Hall for Cornwall concert to the Music for Youth Festival and Cornwall Music Festival in Truro Methodist Church, as well as lots of school concerts. They won the festival youth category in 2017 and have recently been experimenting, as we say, so we're looking forward to welcoming them. They're going to sing for you this afternoon Varsang, which is a Swedish traditional piece, Let It Be, arranged by Hart, and there's a slight change to the programme here, so instead of singing Slow Down, they're going to do When I Set Out for Lyonesse, which is based on Thomas Hardy's poem, and finally Baby on Board, arranged by Gareth Churcher. So we welcome the Truro Boys to sing for us this afternoon.
Silver, the bed, kind of small, all power slow.
to Truro Schoolboys with Mark Hounsell and accompanist Louis Fletcher. So that concludes this category this afternoon. The results for those will be announced at the same time as the next category, and we've got a little break in between. Unfortunately, the Carrier Male Choir have had to withdraw due to illness, so we wish them well and hope to hear from them again very soon. We are going to stick to the times in our programme, so the 41 Voices and Over category will instead begin at 13:50, so it won't start at 1:30, which gives you a little bit of time to pop over to the Hall for Cornwall and get some tickets for tonight's fantastic gala concert, or perhaps for tomorrow. So this evening's concert features Voces 8. We've also got the Epsom Male Choir and the Weybridge Male Choir and the South West Young Voices. So if you want to get tickets for that, I think they are still available at the Hall for Cornwall. It promises to be a fantastic evening. And there's another gala concert tomorrow featuring Only Men Allowed, who you may remember from the BBC Last Choir Standing competition. So you've got time to have a bit of a break, get your tickets, and we look forward to seeing you again later on this afternoon. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
you'd like to take your seats, we're just about ready to start this afternoon's session. Ladies and gentlemen, we're just about to start. Dith Dar, hello and welcome back to this wonderful afternoon of singing. Hopefully the sounds of these great voices will cheer up this slightly miserable day. So we come now to the 41 voices and over category. We welcome once again our adjudicators, Jakob Martinets, David Sadlier, Christopher Gray and Dobrinka Tabakova, chaired by the Artistic Director, Gareth Churcher. So this afternoon we have two choirs competing. If you weren't with us earlier, sadly the Carrier Male Voice Choir have had to pull out due to illness, so we wish them all the best. So we'll begin with the Leveni Male Voice Choir, directed by Marcus Elaine with their accompanist Mel Farley. And they're going to sing for us Tears in Heaven by Eric Clapton and Kirby Shaw, Nearer My God by James Stevens, and One and All, which is a traditional folk tune. Welcome the Leveni Male Voice Choir. thank you so very much to the Leveni Male Voice Choir for starting off this category for us. So I can tell you a little bit about the choir while the millions of them are making their way around the cathedral. So this choir was founded in 1971 at the Carnglaze Caverns, which many of you will know as a concert venue anyway, near St Neot, the Cornish village that they still call their home. And they take their name rather beautifully from the River Leveni, which runs through the village. I'm told that the choir aim to maintain the highest standards of male choral singing, which we've certainly heard this afternoon, but always keeping in mind the importance of entertaining audiences, and from the amount of clapping that we had there, it sounds like you felt you were entertained. They're also keen to support local charitable organisations whilst enjoying themselves and supporting each other in fellowship. And I know from talking to many of the choirs throughout the festival that community spirit plays a huge part. And that's not just about the people who were up there singing and about their directors and accompanists. It's about many of you, the people who were here this afternoon. So on behalf of the choirs, I would like to say thank you to all of you who work behind the scenes. I know there's a lot that goes into it aside from just the singing. This choir do a great deal of performing and travelling overseas and have performed quite recently in France, Italy, Malta, the Netherlands, and most recently in Belgium, where they had the privilege of singing at the last post ceremony in the Menin Gate Memorial in Ypres, in the presence of over 2,000 people. They tell us it was a very emotional experience which will live with them all forever. So they were expertly led by musical director Marcus Alain, who is the holder of the Ellen Windsor Trophy for Best Conductor at the 2019 festival. He's a man of many talents, enormous enthusiasm, and an abiding love of music. So we're shortly going to be hearing from the Mousel Male Voice Choir, who I think are coming up very shortly. I'd also just like to tell you a little bit about the workshops that have been taking place during the festival. So it's not only about the concerts. Our Cornish school children here have had the opportunity to work with and to listen to some of these fabulous visiting choirs that we've had. So we've had workshops taking place in Penzance, in Liscard, and here in Truro, and taking part in those, helping our younger students and inspiring them, have been the Truro boys, the Knaben Cantori Basel, both of whom you heard earlier, the Atlantic Boy Choir, who we're going to be hearing from in a short time, for Tisibros, who you may remember from yesterday's competition, and the Jesuelda Six. These events are a really special part of the festival, I have to say, and as well as inspiring our young singers here in Cornwall, they provide a great CPD opportunity for the teachers who attend them as well. This afternoon, our choirs are competing for trophies for the best UK choir, for the best Cornish choir, which was donated the trophy by Pendennis Shipyard, and also for the best single piece of music, that's the certificate. And there is prize money at stake as well this afternoon, I believe, of £1,000 for the first prize and £400 for the second prize. So the Mousel Male Voice Choir has a repertoire of considerable musical diversity, and this year the choir is going to celebrate 113 years of singing, which is an incredible feat, is it not? They're the second oldest and largest male choir in Cornwall, and in the early days we're told that they travelled to concerts by horse-drawn wagonette, which I suspect they may be returning to if the diesel prices and petrol prices continue to rise as they are. Perhaps we'll all be arriving on horseback next time. So this choir has grown in size and reputation, with a membership of 80 and over now. In 1933, the choir made the first of over 100 BBC radio broadcasts and also introduced its successful summer festival concerts. Special guests with the choir have included Benjamin Luxon, Valerie Masterton, Dame Felicity Lott, and Sabrin Turfel. And in 1956, they were the first Cornish choir to appear on television. There's also a deep and long-lasting link between the choir and the Pendy lifeboat from the RNLI's first days in the village. I'm sure many of you will be familiar with that lifeboat and its story. And as with many of our festival choirs, they do enjoy touring. They've sung in Germany, Brittany, California and Wales, and as well as participating in the massed Cornish choir gatherings at the Royal Albert Hall. The choir performs 20 to 30 times a year, and that includes the ever popular open air concerts which take place on the harbour side in Mousel. And quoting one of their previous musical directors, the choir tell us that their aim is to give us a brilliant performance, whether a prize be won or not. So it's all about the singing. So we welcome Mousel to sing for us this afternoon. Thank you.
Thank you.
thank you so very much to the Mousel Male Voice Choir with Stephen Laurie and Annette Hurton. So our adjudicators are going to leave us for a while now, so a bit of deliberating, and we are going to be entertained by the Atlantic Boy Choir. I have to say, I really would like to pay tribute to these larger choirs that we've got here with us today. I know the pandemic has made meeting terribly difficult for all of you, and to be told just 2 years ago now that we weren't allowed to sing anymore, I know for those of us involved in the music world was absolutely heartbreaking. And I think it's fantastic to see these larger choirs surviving and back singing live for us. So thank you to all of you for keeping the music going. So in a minute we'll be hearing from the Atlantic Boy Choir, and singing really is something that brings lots of us together. I know for those of us involved in choirs, we miss the socialising aspect of it and often involved with family during the times that we couldn't be together. And we actually have two very special guests with us here this afternoon, because the Atlantic Boy Choir, who have their home in Canada, have one of their members who hails from Scotland but now lives in Canada. And his grandparents have flown all the way from Scotland to Cornwall to hear him sing. So we hope that you enjoy it, and we're really glad that you can be here with us today. So this afternoon they're going to be under the directorship of founding member Jennifer Martinet and Brandon Olson, with their accompanist Joshua Tomeo. Oh, John's just doing a bit of chair rearranging for us, because I think there's going to be a different entry. So the Atlantic Boy Choir is the first and only provincial choir of boys and young men in Canada. It was founded in 2016, and the singing ambassadors of Newfoundland and Labrador are selected singers from across the province that are inspired by the famous European SATB model. It provides artistic training for over 120 boys and young men from the age of 4 to 22, which is really quite something, isn't it? So we welcome the Atlantic Boy Choir all the way from Canada.
Thank you. Thank you. played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift, the apple king composing hallelujah. There's a God above, but all I've ever learned from love was how to shoot somebody who outdrew ya. And it's not a cry that you hear at night, it's not somebody who has seen the light. It's a call. Oh,
The Atlantic Boy Choir, ladies and gentlemen, I really think they deserve another round of applause. I don't know about you, but I found it quite difficult not to stand up and dance during that last number. So we promised you an afternoon of glorious singing, and we've certainly had that here at the Cathedral. If you would like to hear more, there is lots more singing still taking place throughout the festival. So tonight we've got the International Gala Concert at the Hall for Cornwall, and there are also several regional gala concerts happening throughout the county tonight, and another gala concert tomorrow. So still tickets available for all of those if you would like to join us for more fantastic singing throughout the festival. We're shortly going to be welcoming our artistic director and the adjudicators back to give us their thoughts on what they've heard this afternoon. Thank you for joining us.
gents, if I can ask you please to take your seats. And we'll have a little bit quiet in the cathedral while we approach one of the most important points of the day, where we're going to be announcing our prizes, not just for this, sorry, the two classes that we've had this afternoon, but we also have some overall festival awards to give also. Before I introduce you to two of our adjudicators, Dr. Jakub Martinek and David Savia, who are going to give the choir some feedback on their performances generally today, just a reminder to choirs that they will also be sent in due course overall feedback from all the adjudicators, which gets compiled, and with greatest respect to our adjudicators, some of the handwriting is quite sometimes difficult to read, so we'll type it all out and then you can read that at your own leisure. We've obviously had two or three people that have been absolute linchpins to the competition events. That's our compere. So could I ask you to give your sign of appreciation for David Hughes, David Peters and the wonderful Christine Judge for all their wonderful compere. This is also our last event in the cathedral for 2022 CIMCF, so my sincerest thanks to all of the cathedral staff, in particular Roger Bush, who stood at the back, who's been a fantastic supporter of this event. Thank you, Roger, so much for your hospitality. Just one small sentiment from me before we hear from our adjudicators, and it's relevant to the choirs that we have here today. The pandemic, as De Brinker was saying yesterday, has caused major problems, none more so to singing in educational establishments, and also obviously large groups of people. So to have two boy choirs is phenomenal, and to have two choirs fielding over 40 voices is an absolute testament to the commitment of those directors and individuals coming and making this thing happen. So thank you so much for everything that you've done to make it happen. Over to David Sadler and Dr. Jakub Martinek.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. What a fantastic afternoon of music making. This is my fourth time adjudicating at this wonderful competition. And I must tell you that Cornwall International Male Festival is the largest festival of its kind in the world. And I have no idea how Gareth Churcher and his team brought this together after pandemic in such a fantastic level. Congratulations to them. Over the past 2 days, we heard wonderful, wonderful performances. And as I mentioned, the level is really, really high this year. All the choirs were really well prepared. And I would like to thank all the singers, but not only to them, to all the conductors and to their accompanists and the staff that's around them, all the volunteers that made this happen. So bravo to all of you. Big round of applause to all the choirs. I will now pass the word to Dr. David Sadler from University of Texas.
Well, good afternoon. It's been such an honor to be here, and again, echoing all words of thanks and praise for Gareth and the organizers of this festival. I've said so many times through it that it's been just the tightest run ship, which I think is appropriate in Cornwall, because that is obviously your area of expertise, but it is, it's just been amazing, the groups, the way the festival is run, and it's been such an honor to be part of it. One of the things that has struck me about the festival, the job of a singer is not about replicating the black dots on the page, right? That was the job of the composer. The job of the singer isn't just about the scribbles that we see as language. That was the job of the poet. Our job isn't on the page. Our job is bringing all those things together, drawing lines between the words and the notes and being able to communicate to the audience. And there's been such an amazing communicative energy from the choirs here. So much joy, so much commitment, so much passion in the eyes of every singer on the stage, every conductor, every pianist, all the percussionists, all the various musicians we've heard. And it has just been such an honor to be here, to be part of it. I was brought back a little bit in some of the men's chorus stuff. That is what originally got me into vocal music at all. I was a rock and roll guy. I played drums and guitar and bass. And I went to an all-male high school, and I ended up singing the choirs. And we wore red and white also today, so I was thinking, oh, that was a bit of a flashback. But such an amazing thing for these male voices to come together in this way to share music, share the text, share the communication with everyone, and it's just been such an honor to be here, to be able to listen, to be able to enjoy, and be able to share a few comments with everyone. So thank you again to the organizers, thank you to the choirs, all the people that go in to bring this together, and I wish you all luck and safe travels following this, but it's been a real honor. Thank you.
So, to the moment some of you have all been waiting for, the prizes. And we're going to start with our youth class. As we've only had two entries in both the categories, and what I shall do is announce the winners. I also won't be giving any marks presently. These will all be available on our website and via our social media platforms, because that might well, from the astute among you, might well give away some of the overall prizes. Can you see the reason behind it? Good. Any problems, come and see me afterwards. So, in our youth choral competition, first prize, with the Slate Trophy and the John Langdon Cup, was Carnarvon Cantore Basil. Conductor, if you'd like to come down and accept the trophy and the certificate and the slate, there are some prizes down here for you. Just while we're going through the photograph situation, could I have a representative and a huge round of applause for the second prize winners? That's Truro School Boys Barbershop. Category, we also have a special prize for the most entertaining performance, which is adjudicated by our very own Russell Pascoe. I always love sitting next to Russell when we take part in these competitions, because at some point he always cries. So I sort of knew which performance had won, which piece had won this competition, because as I looked over, he was most definitely crying. So the special prize for the most entertaining performance with the Kelwood Cup is It Don't Mean a Thing by Carnarvon Cantore Basil. So to the 41 Voices in Over category, again, announcing the winners of this category, who will also therefore win the Best UK and Best Cornish Choir within this category, with it being two Cornish entries. And the first prize of £1,000 goes to Laveni Melvoice Choir. Yeah! Congratulations goes to our second prize winners with a prize of £400. Let's have a huge round of applause for the Mousel Male Voice Choir. This is where things get ever so slightly complicated, because now our adjudicators have to think back over the last 24, 48 hours to decide the overall prizes. Again, hence the reason we didn't give out any marks, because we're also marking these comparably, relevantly, so that we can understand where choirs sit in with all the whole competitions. So we have the best overall UK and best Cornish choir. This goes to the Celtic Male Ensemble. Just to build a bit of tension, and this has been done intentionally, not that I may have forgotten another award in the over 41 voices category, but there was also the best single piece of music in the 41 voices and over category. That also went to Laveni Melville Squire for one and all. We then have a prize that's open to all categories, youth and adult, for the best overall conductor of the festival. The adjudication panel took quite some time to deliberate on this, taking into consideration many, many factors, but in the end we're unanimous in their decision that the best overall conductor for the CIMCF 2022 is Benedikt Kantor. to bring to a close our competition events and awards, we are proud to give an overall champion choir award. This year, that goes to Fortissibros. As soon as we've dragged them all the way up to the front, should we have one more song from Fortissibros? Benedict, is that okay? So just while they take the stage, a few more thank yous from me. We've been so well looked after by members of the City of Truro and Melville Choir, who logistically have managed to organise the choirs coming to and from the warm-up rooms. Absolutely phenomenal. And that has all been led off by one gentleman in reality who is a background hero, if you like. He's probably going to tell me something that I've forgotten to mention in a moment, but I think John Lark should take a huge round of applause for all the work that he's done. Adjudication room downstairs, we've been looked after immensely well by two ladies, Sue Lancaster and Becky Furs, who have been organising all the paperwork and quite wonderful teas and coffees and cakes as well. So thank you very much, Becky and Sue. Our adjudication panel are just taking their seats, but please give them a sign of your appreciation once more for their wonderful adjudication. Best way to leave it than with music. Have a very, very safe journey home. We hope to see you at some of the other events, in particular the Hall for Cornwall ones that are happening in the next 72 hours. Have a lovely rest of the festival, and we hope to see you all again in 2024. Over to Fortissibros.
Everything seems by your love. time of nothing and nothing at all.